plastic surgeon and dermatologist. What a honor.
You got a 2-for-1.
No, Lou, we have a dermatologist, a plastic surgeon, and a pharmacist specialized in cosmetology. I mean, this is a perfect team.
We have a pharmacist that came up with a unique and novel way to do skincare. And I got to congratulate you about that. Tell me a little about Universkin and what inspired you.
Well, Universkin, above all, started as a community of doctors. A community of doctors, but we were not happy with the existing offer. Because as doctors, we see individuals. We see individual people with individual skin needs. And every time we see a face, we're thinking, what is the best product? And we didn't have enough freedom to say, can I have one product, just the ideal product for this person? I have to pick a little bit of this, a little bit of that. And finally, he give 5 or 6 products, but the texture is not adapted. But finally, the dose that I had was maybe too much or not enough. So the idea is to deconstruct the whole skincare offer and reconstruct it and adapt it to our needs as doctors, as you, as doctors, as dermatologists, as a plastic surgeon. So that was the idea of Universkin. Then the second part of Universkin, which is very unique, is to make it fresh, freshly blended, which is key for the efficacy of ingredients. I mean, you know vitamin C, you know arbutin, you know retinol, but the problem we have today is that when we, the pharmacists, we have to formulate for stability. So we have to make a product that is stable for 3 years on the shelves. And this created a lot of difficulties, and we have to make a lot of compromises. So we have to put preservatives, high level of preservatives, we have to put colorants, we cannot marry one active with another because it's not compatible. So actually, a lot of compromises. Why? Because the factory is very far away from the user. So the factory sometimes is hundreds, thousands of kilometers far away. So our idea is to bring the factory next to the user. So likewise, the product is just created before the use. And by doing this, we are finally able to formulate for efficacy in a more natural way, without preservatives, without colorants, and make a freshly blended product adapted for the needs of its user. And the last part, the last innovation of Universkin is that we have created a unique platform where all the doctors are connected to this platform since 2 years ago. And all this platform is also the knowledge of each doctor that is connecting. But all everybody in the university community can share it. So this platform is Kinexis. We're going to talk later about this. So I let also Shito and Julie to introduce yourself for the audience from Universkin, because of course we know you now since 2016, and you are great friends. But I let you just very shortly introduce ICLS, which is one of the best center in whole Canada. And just very shortly see who you are, what you're doing, and
I'll stop.
My name is Dr. Julie Cano. I'm a board certified plastic surgeon in Canada and the US, and I am co-founder of ICLS, where we have a very, very large cosmetic clinic doing all aspects of injectables, skincare, all the way to major surgery, overnight patients. And it's a very unique environment because we offer everything and we try to pick and choose what's right for the patient. So we really are all about tailor-making things, and that's why our relationship with Universkin has been so powerful, because that's always been our motto. Look at the patient, what the patient needs today, because that might be different in 2 years from now, and it might be different than 5 years from now. So that's why it's such a great fit with you, Harry, and with Universkin.
I'm Sheetal Sapra. Julie is my partner, both in the office and in real life. I'm a dermatologist, and as a dermatologist, I truly believe everyone deserves beautiful skin. When I first heard about Universkin, I said, no way. Somebody's actually gonna let me produce a factory in my office to do a product that I want, that's unique, and made especially for the patient in front of me? Shocked me. I said, this is not possible. So I got on a plane, and I flew to Nice. And I spent a day with Harry, and a dermatologist. And it was unique. I'm a dermatologist with all in the pharma industry. But Universkin did something pretty unique. It brought in a base that was essentially low in preservatives and suited almost every skin tone. But what they did is take cosmeceuticals or activators. So I have agents to treat acne. I have agents to take sun damage away. I have agents to take color away. And I can take a look at a patient's skin and mix and match up. I found that really exciting. I like this product, and I think the best innovation and a new innovation that's really unique, especially in these COVID times when we're caught in our house, is this amazing questionnaire that Harry produced by taking the knowledge from thousands of dermatologists, using artificial intelligence, and putting it into software. And the link is in our bio, in my bio. So you can fill in what you want, get the skincare, and it will actually be delivered to you as well. Tell us about Skin Access, Harry.
Okay. So actually, Skin Access, I invite everybody else to go YouTube in the Universkin chain and take the video with Thierry, our CTO, but he's developed all this technology. Skin Access is a unique platform when patients can connect with doctors remotely, which means from house, they can either send just a photo, either send a photo and fill a very detailed dermatological questionnaire. But we make it fun. I mean, it's really fun to fill it. It takes maximum 10 minutes of your time. You have to put a photo at the end. Please don't put a photo with makeup, put a photo with white light. We can see really your face. And Dr. Sapra and his team, they will receive all your information. Just to let you know that Skin Access is a teledermatology platform, so your data is safe. It's considered like medical data. And he will be able to check all the data. So of course there is artificial intelligence, but I don't like this word, it's collective intelligence, because it's the intelligence of all the doctor community that is on the system. So this collective intelligence will be assisting Dr. Sapra to have you a preliminary diagnostic. Of course, he will modify it in relation to what he's seeing, and he will assist Dr. Sapra also to create a formula. So actually it's like having an AI assistant. Why? Because I mean, you can imagine to have a full dermatological consultation, it takes at least 1 hour, an hour and a half. Why I say 1 hour and a half? You go to wake up, go to your car, come to your clinic, wait for your appointment, meet with Dr. Sapra, get your product, and then take your car and be home. Now you can do everything remotely. And the advantage we have is that Dr. Sapra, he will be able to manage more patients, safer, faster, and better. We didn't make the Skin Access due to the COVID. I mean, now is a great opportunity, but it makes part of our belief to make Universkin widely accessible. I mean, when I met you guys, it's true, you take the plane and you came in your own expenses in France to get trained. You spend 2 days to understand how it works, and it's remarkable. And by spending time with you also, Sheetal, is not to make a compliment. I see a huge knowledge in dermatological conditions, because and the end of the story is not about skin beauty, it's about skin health, okay? And all this knowledge you have, this amazing knowledge, this deep knowledge on the skin and conditions, what happened beneath the skin, how to stimulate, what to do, what not to do, how to construct the right skin. All this knowledge should be accessible. People, they are lost. We are 7.7 billion, and everybody use someone else's cream. They will use the cream of an influencer, they will use the cream of a friend, they will use the cream of a model they see on the magazine. But in the end of the story, it's not the wrong cream. And people, they don't get, I mean, they get the wrong advice about the skincare routine. And what we believe is that life is so busy, you don't need to spend time. Just delegate to the doctor your skincare routine. They are able to do it. And they will do it, why? Because 80% of facial aesthetics and beauty is what you do at home. So it is your own interest, if you want to make this really top, to have the right skincare routine at home. So people they should come, connect with you, delegate to you the skincare routine, and you will do it without any kind of interest. Because what is your main concern is to keep the skin health and the glowing skin great. This is the main concern. People, they should understand that the way we are thinking is a service we want to provide. People were spending so much time. I mean, so many times I go to friends and, you know, I'm curious. I always open, you know, the bathroom to see what is inside. First of all, I want to check if I use my own products. So. But you see so many products inside the bathroom. It's packed. And ask them, do you use all of this? No, I try this one, it's good. I try this one, but I stop it. Finally, they have things, but almost expiring there. Yeah. Thousands of dollars.
I'm sure you're lying. They were expired. You know, and being a woman, when everyone's telling you, like you said, you're hearing what's good, what's good, what's good, you can get overwhelmed. And you don't know which ones to pick and choose. And for me, I like the simplicity. I always say I don't do girl well. You know, I'm not good at 50,000 washes and 50,000 steps. And I love having simple things. You know, I believe in the KISS principle. Keep it simple, stupid. You know, so it's like, okay, Julie, your skin needs this. Great. All over that. I can do that.
I love that aspect of it being unique and bespoke to the patient itself. But your actives are pretty amazing, Harry. You pick actives not only that I can use in dermatology, but also actives that I can use in cosmeceuticals. So I can take somebody where they may have some pigment and some acne and mix up the ingredients. I can mix up some azelaic acid to deal with the color and the acne, some salicylic acid to exfoliate them, some niacinamide to get them done. And sometimes you need more than three actives. I was a member of IMCAS and with Dr. Khanna, he made up that beautiful for her melasma with the arbutin. It was amazing what we can do for our patients.
And that's a great example. I have darker skin, problem skin, because it's hard for products for me. And I met Harry and I've been getting some more melasma later in life, which was kind of weird, not in pregnancy. And Harry was right all over it and mixed me up a formula. He said in 3 months it's going to be better. And 100% it was.
Thank you so much. But this is also the beauty of Universkin. By playing to the concentrations, exactly as Sheetal explained, and of course this concentration is not available to everybody. This is the reason that we have only doctor dispensed. By playing with the concentration, you go from a cosmeceutical to almost a topical medication, and then you can reduce the dosage to go to everyday product that can be used as a cosmeceutical. You can marry medical indications, wrinkles and pimples, for example. I mean, sometimes it's true. You see patients, they have pimples and wrinkles, and you just want to make one product for them. So I just get profit of having two doctors that they are very experienced in treating the pigmentation. And now with the lockdown, everybody will be in. Nobody will be out of the sun. So tell me your secrets about, first of all, when you see a patient with stubborn pigmentation, but most probably when they come to your practice, you already try home peelings, you already try to buy products from the drugstore, and when they come to you, it's a nightmare, and you have to treat this. How you manage this patient? How you manage this demand of get rid of pigmentation?
Pigmentation is difficult. I think the most important thing to do, sunscreen is very important. To use a mineral-based sunscreen is essential. And often you need agents that will help lighten the skin. And this is the unique thing about Universkin. I can take arbutin, I can take azelaic acid, I can take kojic acid and put it in different concentrations and apply that to the skin once a day. And I can even add hydroquinone during the day. And we can do in-office treatments such as laser toning or a hydroquinone mask to get you a lot better. But having Universkin and having that ability to mix arbutin, azelaic, and kojic, niacinamide, a little bit of vitamin A, sometimes vitamin C, I can mix up different products for patients to get them the results that they want.
And of course, the most important is then to follow up to stabilize it, because for me, for what, the way I see melasma, but you treat it much more and in a very impressive way in your clinic, it's that you need to have, to educate the patient as well. You need to educate the user, but this should not be to go too fast, because skin has a memory. You cannot change the memory just like this.
Exactly.
I mean, how you, okay, you come to the clinic, they get the high dosage of arbutin, niacinamide, you get rid of the pigmentation, you have some laser, some peelings. How you maintain them after? What you do to maintain them?
I think the most important thing in melasma is sunscreen, so we maintain that. And then we use the natural products that are very safe in Universkin, usually the night cream. And we will do some in-office treatment, some laser toning or a dermoclad mask once or twice a year. Melasma is hard. It comes back all the time. So it's like a disease you have to stay on top of. Sun avoidance, sun protection, use your lightening agents, do your in-office treatments. That's how we handle melasma.
And the antioxidants, of course.
Yeah.
What do you think about the melasma? Is it also an inflammatory process? Is it also inflammation? because sometimes on fair skin we can see the redness, but in olive skin types we don't see the redness. But is there inflammation beneath? What's your opinion?
Oh, definitely this low-grade inflammatory process. So many times in melasma, not only do we do skincare and we do treatments in office, but sometimes we'll do laser treatments just to help with the inflammation and do low-dose vascular lasers and stuff like that. Harry, I want to ask you something. You brought out this skincare line, and you recently, when I was in Paris, you showed me this absolutely amazing cleanser based on olive oil. Tell me about that cleanser, and why did you make that? Because I always thought a cleanser is a cleanser. What's so unique about this?
Look, in Universkin, we don't make new products if we don't really believe that we have something new to bring. And I was looking to the people habits, and I was more and more conscious that the habits of people has changed. The females, the women, they use more and more stubborn makeup, so waterproof. They want to have the makeup that stays almost the whole day. Also, they're using mineral sunscreens because thank God, thanks to the dermatologist's work, more and more people are switching to mineral sunscreens. And those formulations were on the skin. When, for example, you use micellar water, and then you check after cleaning the face how much residual product you have on the skin, you just get conscious that still 50% of this stubborn makeup of sunscreen is still on the skin. And the only way really to get rid of it, to clean it, is through oil. Because they are oil-based, they are water-free and oil-based, because in order to disperse the minerals, they have either silicone, either oil formulas. Most of the makeup, if it is waterproof, has no water, okay? So actually to get rid of all this and have a clean skin, which is key, you need oil. And also the pollutants, all the pollutants, the people living in the city, taking the plane, okay, this is not the case for the moment, but the pollutants, they are soluble in oil, they're not soluble in water. So everybody's talking about pollution, and you know there are more and more studies showing that the pollution is increasing the chronic inflammation, the low-grade inflammation, so it's accelerating the skin aging. So if we want to get rid of these pollutants, we need to get an oil cleanser. So we say, okay, we get micellar water, was the 2000. Now we need to think a new generation of cleansers because the habits of the people have changed. More and more people is adapting sunscreen. More and more people is adapting waterproof makeup. So we need to follow up what the people are using, the pollutants. Now it's a clinical evidence that pollutants accelerate the skin aging. So we say oil, and then we start thinking, what's the best oil we can use? And we decide to use olive oil, not only because I'm Mediterranean, and not only because the company is based in Nice. Olive oil because, first of all, it's a great way to acidify the skin. The olive oil, if you see the high-quality olive oil, they say you acidity guarantee. Why is it important to acidify your skin while cleaning? Because the pH of the skin is acid. And if you don't need to use a glycolic cleanser to acidify your skin. The olive oil can do it. It's the only oil with acidic pH. Second, the olive oil is full of antioxidants. It's full of antioxidants. It has all the polyphenols. It's oleic acid. Olive oil also is very good. Cast is a great thing to clean the skin.
And that sounds so counterintuitive that you're putting oil on acne skin. I remember I said that to you. I said, I'm acne prone. I'm not going to use oil on my skin. That's crazy.
Yeah, but olive oil is the best. Yeah. And at the same time, our cleanser can be used not only to clean the face, can be used also to the scalp. Because the scalp is a big problem. I mean, more and more people, they have dermatitis of the scalp because they use dyes, stressful lifestyle, too much shampoo, and it can be used on the scalp also, like a mask. When you put the shampoo, it can be used to clean the face, the stubborn makeup, the sunscreen. So it's universal, and this is what we like. We like products that is only for everyone. So it's a new generation of cleanser. It has 70% of olive oil inside. I mean, when you open the product, people will say, "Smells like olive oil." I say, "Yes, it's 70% olive oil." But we have no emulsifiers. It's a very specific technology we have used. We have inside lavender and chamomile, but it's coming from very special extracts, but they are free of any kind of allergens. Of course, we have a 10% chamomile oil, so almost 80% of oil inside. And this is important because when people buy oil cleansers, they say, okay, it has oil inside, but most of the oil cleansers, they have, let's say 50, 60% of mineral oil. And then they put just a little bit of oil, like jojoba oil or cocoa oil. But in the end of the story is mineral oil, which is good to clean, but it doesn't bring any additional benefit to the skin. And it didn't acidify the skin. For me, the cleanser has two missions. Clean and get rid, leave a clean face. Leave a face without a destroyed skin barrier, and leave a face with an acidic pH. If a cleanser can do this, it's a perfect cleanser. I don't know what you think, Shito.
You know, I like it. Olive oil is natural. And the way you formulated it, it has very few preservatives, so people aren't going to react to it. And I like the fact that it's a cleanser I can give to almost anyone. Acne prone, dry skin, sensitive skin. It's beautiful. I did have this problem with oil and oily skin, but after I saw it work, I truly believe it's a great cleanser.
I think the other thing is even post-procedure patients, it's very, very gentle. So they tolerate it really, really well as well, which is exciting as well. Tells you how good it is and how soft it is on your skin.
Great. Just one more question. I'm going back to pigmentation, but I have a question. I mean, I'm reading all the studies about blue lights and pigmentation. In the beginning, 2 years ago, I was like, come on, blue light and pigmentation. And now I see more and more studies saying that the blue light, especially in olive phototypes for 3, 4 and the top, with really clinical evidence, but it has an impact on the melasma. So what do you think about this? I mean, people should use sunscreen even during night when they are faced to the smartphone. What's your opinion?
I think you have to wear sunscreen every day, Harry, from morning to night, because everyone thinks sunscreen is only for going out in the sun. Do you only brush your teeth when you want to go out to meet people? You brush your teeth every day. Good, clean teeth. And we only thought that sun and only ultraviolet light is what causes melasma. But you brought out a really interesting point. Different kinds of light. The blue light in front of your computer all the time. The just the ambient light. Sitting next to a window, you're still getting UV. So the thing about pigmentation, melasma, and post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, use your actives. Use the right cleanser, have sunscreen on every single day.
So actually, basically, a successful skincare routine is just 3 steps. Clean your face with the right products, treat with the right serum, put the moisturizer on the top if you need, if you have a very dry skin, and then put your sunscreen, that's it.
You got a dermatology degree, Harry.
I was teaching by the top, so. Just a few more questions, tips and tricks for our audience, and then we start answering the questions. I always wondering about the eye contour, and during spring, especially everybody has allergies, has a swollen eye contour, and you saw me a formula you have created with rutin and SOD and niacinamide for the eye contour with very great results. You want to share this formula, your secret university formula with the people who are listening to us? Why rutin on the eye contour?
It's a good anti-inflammatory agent. I think rutin and niacinamide are good anti-inflammatory agents. They work well to take the inflammation away. When you take the inflammation away, you take the swelling away. The SOD is amazing because it's a great antioxidant. But now, recently, I've been starting adding DMAE just because you get that muscle relaxation that comes from the DMA. It just softens the skin and gives your eyes a pop when they come out to it. There's little ingredients and little secrets most of us have. But as you did your survey in those 2,000 dermatologists, it's amazing how when you're doing the right thing, most of us have the right formulas. And that's why I like the Skin Access platform so much.
Yes, I mean, to all the people that are listening, either you're in Canada, either you're in US, either you're whatever, and you want really to have a formula by one of the top experts, formulators I ever met in my life, go to ICLS, go to your Instagram. I think the Skin Access is already in your bio. Connect with Dr. Sakra, ICLS Clinic, and the team, and you will get the best formula available. I mean, this team is really amazing. I don't know if it's a compliment, but... You know, what makes Universkin is who makes Universkin. We just make this stuff, but you make the formulas. And sometimes when I see the results and the formulas you get out of it, this is where we see the great interaction. So what makes Universkin? Who makes Universkin? And actually, you make Universkin. You make great formulas.
You gave us the tools to do it, Harry. I really appreciate that. Let's take some questions.
Yes, of course.
I was going to say another thing that's really important about Universkin that I think we miss a lot in our aesthetic market is men. So if you can give men a product that's mixed, custom made to them, and no smell, nothing, you know, not too bothersome, I think that's a huge aspect where Universkin has a great niche as well. So you can say to a guy, okay, I'm going to give you one cream. Okay, that's it. I'm not going to ask you to do two steps. I'm not going to ask you to do three. I'm going to give you one thing. And you know what? They're really open to that because they're not used to having 25 steps or washing, removing makeup, doing this. So if you can keep it simple, that's another huge aspect for Universkin.
No, but for the male users, I mean, most of the common thing is redness, seborrheic dermatitis. We're stressed, and every time we are stressed, we make sebum and we are red. So niacinamide, I love it. My serum is niacinamide dermatica society. And from time to time, I put some zinc and salicylic to get rid of the black points.
Yeah.
And it's perfect. I mean, it's simple, very simple.
Awesome.
So do we have any questions we need to answer? I have Chao, but together with me, and he helped me answer the questions. Okay, let's take one question. Let's have a look. What are the best anti-aging ingredients? So,
good cleanser and sunscreen. Sunscreen is the most essential thing you can do. If there's only one thing you can do, use sunscreen daily. If you're going to ask me what else you should use products that generate collagen and products that take the sun damage away. So antioxidants such as vitamin C, I think, are the baseline of what we should be doing in helping skin get better. Because most of the aging that we see in Canada is photoaging. Because when we age, but the sun causes excessive aging. That's why using sunscreen is important. Formulating products with vitamin C and retin-A are great. But also with Universkin, I can use products that generate collagen, such as isoflavones and macrocyte. I can use other antioxidants, such as zinc oxide and prurin. So there's a lot of options that I have. So sunscreen, an active agent with antioxidants, and a product that generates collagen.
Yes, this is people they thinking about the aging ingredients. And sometimes what is fashionable is the best. According to clinical evidence, what is the ingredients where they have the most clinical evidence in stimulating collagen? So it's retinol, Sandel Asiatica, Matica Society, which is very good for sensitive skin, and of course vitamin C. But vitamin C is also an antioxidant, so it can be both generating collagen, but it's also an antioxidant. I think that those are the most clinical evidence ingredients. Then we have hyaluronic acid, which is great also. But hyaluronic acid, it has two functions: repair the skin barrier, but can go deep if it is a small size. And of course, if you want to use good dermis enhancers, if I can give an advice from a marketing point of view, you need to be consistent. I see people changing the anti-aging cream almost with every new advertising campaign. And anti-aging cream is number one sunscreen, zinc titanium sunscreen. Second is stick to one product and follow up. I mean, if you go to the gym and you make 2 weeks Pilates, 2 weeks power yoga, 2 weeks whatever, you're going to finish with a back pain, but you will not get fit. So you need to be consistent. And your personal trainer is your derm. So in the anti-aging ingredients, especially, don't be impatient. Be consistent. And of course, if you want the best anti-aging effect, do not hesitate to follow up neurotoxins, fillers, and skincare. You need to work on the three levels. And you need to start young. This is what I see.
I think starting young is essential. And young is, use your sunscreen daily, use a product with active ingredients that's going to take some of the sun damage and generate collagen. And yes, go on to Botox and filler and tightening devices as we need it. But skincare is basically the foundation of beautiful skin.
You know, even with facelifts, we talk about I can take away quantity of skin, but I can't change quality of skin. And if we don't have that glow to our skin, that's really, that ages us. You know, when we look at a baby, when we look at youth, it's the glow. And that's what we're trying to get. And Universkin lets us play with different additives for every patient to pick that ingredient or that combination of ingredients that helps get your skin to glow.
Of course. And we finally have
a
aging.
Surgeon excited about skincare.
Exactly.
How many times do you see a plastic surgeon excited about
time.
Skincare?
Look,
time.
More and more. More and more with your plastic surgeons because.
Skincare and beauty.
They see the skin, when they cut the skin and they make facial surgery, they see the quality of the skin. So they know how important it is to work in a good quality of skin. Just the last point about anti-aging, because people, when thinking about anti-aging, they don't think the anti-inflammatory actives. And there is the key actives in anti-aging is niacinamide.
Thank you. Almost every formula will have niacinamide in it. I think it's the secret ingredient in Universkin.
And niacinamide, it's an anti-inflammatory agent, it works on pigmentation, it's a dermis enhancer, but aging is also chronic inflammation. So anti-aging ingredient is a concept, but you have to think, what is the dysfunction of the aging? It's inflammation, it's oxidation, but at the end of the story, what they are doing, they make that the fibroblasts and the collagens, they don't work very well. So your skin became thinner, and the excess of the skin with gravity, it's going down. So actually, it's aging is a multi-inflammatory it's a multifunctional process, and there is not just one miracle at the aging ingredient. There is different approach of aging, so you need to work on this approach. There is the mitochondrial approach, or all the new theories now talk about mitochondrial, but it's a mitochondrial that and oxidative stress that creating. The aging, but I personally believe that aging is a chronic process. UV damage is the most important external factor that accelerates the aging, and at the same time is a question of hygiene, personal hygiene, and what we put on the skin every day. Because the skin will get fooled only by the skin. I mean, we can eat as much food supplements as we want. You know that in terms of bioavailability, the last organ to get nourished when we are eating is the skin. So we need to bring things topical.
Awesome.
Any other questions? So how about white pigmentation? White pigmentation. I'm not sure I understand this question.
When you talk about white pigmentation, I think there's only two things that people really talk about. One is vitiligo, which is a dermatological disease, which Universkin is not going to help much with either. And the other is something called post-inflammatory hypopigmentation. This usually happens in people with darker skin color that get some eczema, they're going to be left with white. At that point, what we do is, there isn't anything in Universkin that will bring the white back. We can try other prescription creams, but it also comes up, the post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, usually from eczema. So using the right moisturizers and using moisturizing products will help. But to bring the white color back, there isn't anything topically that we have right now that's over the counter that will help us with that.
What would be the medication we're going to use?
Usually, when you see your dermatologist, they'll often ask you to use a mild cortisone cream once or twice a week, and they'll even give you mild immunomodulators such as Elidel and Protopic, because they help bring the color back into your skin. And you really have to see a dermatologist when you have white pigmentation to see why it's there. Is it vitiligo? Is it post-inflammatory hypopigmentation? Is it from sun damage called idiopathic guttate hypomelanosis? It's more of a dermatological problem that may need a prescription rather than an over-the-counter. Next question. Any other questions at all, guys?
Yes. Let's take can we use when you're 50s, it's better to avoid alpha hydroxy acids or glycolic acid based lotion?
I think that's
so it's about lotions. I mean,
That's an interesting question, because alpha hydroxy acids, glycolic acid, were the topical most characteristic anti-aging agents. When you're 50, it all depends upon your skin type. Definitely use the right cleanser, use your sunscreen. When you come see us, or when you fill in your questionnaire, we'll see what you do. Do you have sun damage where you need an antioxidant such as vitamin C and vitamin A? Do you need to generate collagen? Do I have to add mycoside, isoflavones, SOD? Do you use glycolic acid? If you have skin that is thick and that needs to be exfoliated, definitely we can use both glycolic acid, phytic acid, and salicylic acid in Universkin to produce some exfoliation. They also do generate collagen, but it'll be something when we assess your skin, we'll see whether it goes or not. It's not a one statement suits everybody. It's going to be unique to when I see you. And if you're 50 and you need AHA, we will put glycolic acid in. And if you don't, we'll put some vitamin C and macrocyte and niacinamide in. It'll all vary depending on what your skin is.
Exactly, and you know also my theory, in dark skin, we have to be very careful with glycolic because it can irritate the skin and create a rebound pigmentation, but not immediately, but within 3 months after. So actually, we need to be careful with exfoliants. When you want to use exfoliants, don't go over the counter. Ask your derm, ask your plastic surgeon, who will know how to guide you. I mean, it's easy, it's cheap. Everybody puts on the products, everybody say it's a miracle ingredient, but it's not an ingredient that you can use all the time and in all skin types. You need to be careful. And your derm is the best person to guide you about what exfoliant, there is so many exfoliants, in which dosage also, in which period of the season, for how much time, and how to combine it. Because sometimes you can use exfoliants. Yes, glycolic is great, but it's better if you're a dark skin to combine it with niacinamide, which is very important in order to avoid very bound pigmentation. If you're acneic skin, maybe you need to combine with azelaic. So actually, yes, exfoliants are interesting. When you're 50, your skin is thinner, but you might have also UV damages with hyperkeratinization. So actually, in order to, let's say, answer correctly, the question is connect to our questionnaire, tell us about your skin, and we can tell you about how to use alpha hydroxy acids.
The other thing I think that's really important to point out is, being 53, nearly 54, the one thing that's important when you're in this age group, there are a lot of changes happening. So one product might be great for 3 months, but you at the 3 month mark, when you come back, it may need to change. So maybe you've addressed one concern, you need to address another, because the hormonal changes that are happening are quite significant in our age group. So, you know, you need to be flexible and you need to look at your skin because it is going to be changing. So we're not going to slot one thing as good for 50-year-olds because it might be good this week, but it may be terrible next week. So that's another nice thing about being able to tailor make the product for your skin at that moment.
We have another question that is interesting. Do I need to go to the clinic to get the products? The answer is no. You can fill your questionnaire. The questionnaire is really connected to Dr. To ICLS. They will check your answers. It's not nobody behind, just a marketing questionnaire. You will see, you will not get an answer immediately. You have to wait 24 hours. If it is a weekend, you have to wait over the weekend, of course. But your questionnaire will be given to the clinic. They will make your formula, and then you can connect. They will have soon, I think, a new online shop, but it will come, and they will be able to mix and ship to your door. So you don't need to go and receive the clinic. What is important is to tell everything about your skin, yes.
Yeah, and we will have a consult with one of the nursing team. We'll talk to you and work your way through the questionnaire and make sure that there's nothing else that's missing as well. And then you can order over the phone. That's not a problem.
So I have another question. Why do I need a personalized skincare? So just to answer to this question, I mean, it's a hot topic because today, I mean, everybody goes in personalization, and we are on this since 2006, let's say 14 years ago. So our philosophy is personalization is not just to have your name of a box and your name of a bottle. It doesn't make sense. Personalization is to have a more efficient product, but it's safe at the same time. This is the key elements for personalization: efficacy with great tolerance. Because efficacy means what? I put high dosages of ingredients. This is the reason you use cosmeceuticals, because you want ingredients, the high dosage, pure ingredients. But at the same time, more you put, more you go up to the efficacy, more you increase the risk of tolerance. So personalization is exactly to find the best efficacy with the best tolerance, because a good skincare should be your second skin, should be perfectly tolerated. So personalization is about efficacy and about tolerance. That's the only two main reasons that push us to make personalization, in order to have the best possible results without any kind of reactions to your skin.
But Harry, to personalize it is also to personalize it to your skin type. If you look at me and Dr. Khanna, we're two totally different people. We can't use the same product. She needs something else with her condition than me. I have oily skin, with sun damage and dark circles underneath my eyes, I have to use something totally different from what Dr. Khanna does. So it isn't the unique thing about personalization, it isn't one thing that fits all. It's a solution designed just for you personally, for you, for your skin type. And I think that's what's unique. That's what really excites me about Universkin.
But the results also, I think I cannot talk about the results because I have a conflict of interest. I mean, it's a product you produce, but you can share your experience also about what you get out of it.
And that's exactly right. That's what I was going to say. You can use over-counter products. If they work for you and you're happy, that's great. But if you expect to see a change in your skin, if you want to see that glow in your skin and you're not getting it, then you need more medical grade, higher levels, and then you might as well pick and choose what's exactly right for what your needs are instead of sort of throwing 100 things at it. Let's target your skin for what the concerns are and deal with those concerns.
What you've done uniquely, Harry, is you can go into any pharmacy and buy a moisturizer. You can go into any pharmacy and buy a cleanser. What you've done is given us active ingredients, nutraceuticals, cosmeceuticals that actually have some activity. It's not like just putting a bland moisturizer you picked up at Costco onto your skin. You actually have something in that product that's going to make a change in your skin slowly, and it's going to give you that skin that you want, that beautiful, shiny, glowing skin. And those active ingredients you've designed are amazing, and that's what makes Universkin so essential.
I said I don't even think it's that slow. I mean, I think after one jar, you know, which lasts about 3 months, you will see if you've targeted a problem or an issue that you want to see an improvement. For me, it was my melasma. After one jar, you will see a difference. And that's kind of cool because I've never had that with an over-the-counter product that I've ever bought. I've never gone, wow, that changed my skin. I've never had that.
Thank you. But it's good that you are talking as a doctor, as a user as well. For my point of view, the only thing I want to say is skincare and skin health is a science. It's not just a remote buying until I find the right product. It's a science. In order to make it work, first of all, you need to delegate your diagnostic to a skin expert, the dermatologist, the plastic surgeon, people they know how it works with skin, but they know the sick skin, the healthy skin, but they understand the balance, but they have a functional approach as well. So you need the great diagnostic. So you need to connect what we call diagnostic, physiology, in medicine with pharmacology. That's it. It's so simple. So if you have this expertise and you make the right diagnostic, you understand the skin, and you pick up the right ingredients with the right vector, and you know what you want, you're going to get results. I mean, it's not a miracle. There is not such a miracle cream.
Exactly.
And at the end, it's freshly blended. This is what we always insist. Freshly blended. What makes the difference? Fresh food is better.
That's what personalized skincare is for you and your issues, and not just
exactly.
Hoping. Cross your fingers. Let's hope this works. It worked for that girl on TV. Maybe it'll work for me. We can take the guesswork out. That's it. It's taking out the guesswork.
Exactly.
It's making it a process, a questionnaire, an analysis, and taking out guesswork. And that's what's really great about it.
And this is one of my biggest challenges when we start this venture with our doctor friends back in 2006, and then again in working and asking questions, is can we make this topical but can be used every day, so skincare, as precise as a mathematical equation? And what we need is material and methods to deliver this to the consumer, to the users. And this is the reason that our products are only dispensed by doctors. It's not because we want to have doctors selling products. I don't think that any doctors need this because they have enough studies, they have enough work to do this. But they know it's part of their job and they need to advise you. So delegate your skincare routine to the right people. This is if I'm saying, if you're happy with your products, stay with your products. If you're not happy, if you want to educate yourself, also understand better why it works, what's good for my skin, what should buy, what should use, delegate your skincare routine to the right people and you will see the difference.
And educate. I asked that same question when I was introduced to Universkin. I said, why do we need personalized skincare? That's why I flew out to Nice. That's why I spent 2 days with you and realized this is the future. This is what most people are going to need. Hey, great restaurant. That restaurant, Nice was
La Petite Maison.
Oh my God, Harry. Last time I was there, Bono was right next to me. The Edge was right next to me. What are all these people doing in Nice? You live in an amazing city and an amazing restaurant.
Thank you. Look, the lockdown is one of the things we are really missing.
Absolutely.
But it's time to cook also. So do we have any other questions we'd like to answer? So I think we are having a lot of questions coming, a lot of questions. I don't think we'll be able to answer everything, but we'll answer after. Okay, best product for scarring. So best for scarring and front fine lines, please. So what would be the best ingredient for scarring?
Scarring is very good. When you have scarring, it depends upon the kind of scarring that you have. If you have red and brown scarring from acne, then we can definitely use products to take that away. If you have depressed scarring from acne, we can use products in Universkin that generate collagen like macrocyte isoflavones to help that a little bit. If you have thick red scars or hypertrophic scars, you really need to be seen by the dermatologist in the office and have some in-office treatments together with a topical silicone gel. Frown lines, in reality, those are those 11s up here. The best treatment for that is Botox every 3 months. You'll have a smooth forehead with no lines. Unfortunately, creams or no skincare will help for that.
I fully agree. And for the scarring, microneedling is helpful?
It all depends on the kind of scarring you have. Microneedling, if you have small, little depressed scarring, what I'll often do is do microneedling, and I'll take niacinamide, macrocyte, isoflavones, do that in the evening, and during the day I'll do microneedling with something called growth factors, which isn't in the Universkin line. All those products help generate collagen and retexturize your skin. Often I'll also add on a Clarisonics brush with the olive oil cleanser, and it will just give you this glow, and the constant stimulation of the Clarisonics brush produces collagen for that kind of acne scarring.
Great, thank you so much.
Great for everything, right? Because it takes whatever product you're using, Universkin, and gets it in deeper.
Let's
so it makes sense that we should be using microneedling for all of our products to get better efficacy out of them.
Of course. So the moment you are able to go just below the stratum corneum, which is the superficial part of the epidermis, most of the ingredients, they are diffusing inside the skin. So you don't really need to go too deep. It's just a barrier, you know, to overcome. And then your result is much better. But this is, an in-office treatment, but it can really help. It can give you a glowing skin. It helps to stimulate the collagen. It's very natural. It's a good tensor for the skin, so it's tightening the skin. And it's part of the things you can do every month, every 2 months. Of course, if you start doing this young, then I guess you will need to use less aggressive procedures later, no?
Yeah.
Don't get rid of my facelifts yet.
So do we have any other questions? What about the comedogenic effect of oils? Okay, that's a very good question. So if you want to be sure that your oil is non-comedogenic, check your products. All our products, we make non-comedogenic tests, and this is the most important. Anybody can say, no, I have this oil is non-comedogenic. Look, the most important is that the finished product you have is tested to be non-comedogenic. So if a product has this test, purchase it. If it doesn't have this test, don't just try to understand yourself with a formula. This is my advice. We do non-comedogenic tests for products that the formulation might have a comedogenic effect. First of all, for us to be sure. So this is the only advice I can give. Check the products. If they have this kind of test, buy it. If it does have this kind of test, don't try to guess.
Agree with you there.
Any other questions, Harry?
Yeah, there are many questions. We can see people have come to take a little bit of your brain, to get a little bit of your knowledge. Okay, there is a question that is a little bit dermatological. Can you treat keratosis pilaris with Universkin?
Yes, I have, and I'll tell you what I'm doing with that. So I'll go through that with you. When you have keratosis pilaris, it's this funny condition where you get bumps on your face, on your arms, and your legs, and it feels rough. And sometimes it will look red and funny, and it looks like you have acne. So what I'll often do with that is I can't cure it, but I can get it a lot better. And what we want to do is exfoliate and moisturize at the same time. So usually I'll take a gentle cleanser, use a Clarisonics brush, which is a cleanser that really smooths the skin down on top. And then usually I'll take some glycolic acid, phytic acid, and salicylic acid, compound it into the Universe substance, put it on, and then Universkin actually makes some really amazing moisturizers. And one of the ones they make is called Next Ultra Balm, which is thick and decreases the inflammation. So we do not take the keratosis pilaris away, but we make it look smoother, feel smoother, and feel less red. It's still there, but it looks better. And sometimes we'll add some cortisone cream on. If it really bothers you a lot, on a scale of 1 to 10, it bugs you 10, we sometimes will do laser just to kill the hair follicles, and this has been shown to improve keratosis pilaris. So a combination of skincare together with laser treatments in office will improve it, but not take it away.
Thank you. I think we are almost coming to the because it's maximum 1 hour. We already almost 55 minutes, but we still have questions. I mean, that doesn't stop. I think
let's do one
make,
more.
Maybe one more live. Okay. What is the most important skincare rules during springtime?
Sunscreen.
And also, do you have to take a look at your skin at that particular point. Often if you're saying, Doc, what would you give me in Universe Skin for that? It all depends on what I see on you. If I see oxidative stress, I'll use antioxidants such as vitamin C. If I see comedones or a little bit of sun damage going, I may use some vitamin A. And if I want to generate collagen, you can use mycocyte, isoflavin, SOD, acrylic acid, and niacinamide. So, if you're asking me, gentle cleanser, sunscreen, and some active ingredients on your skin picked by your dermatologist to improve the texture, tone of your skin, and for its anti-aging effect.
If I can add only something, is use a lighter moisturizer, because during winter people they use very thick moisturizers. So maybe when the temperature is going up a little, you can use a lighter texture. Of course you can feel it. If your skin is tight, stick to the texture you're using. But this is also a classical mistake I see skincare routine. People, they keep with a moisturizer during the springtime, they don't go to a lighter moisturizer. And I think this is also something, tips and tricks that people can take home. But anyway, for all those questions, everybody that's asking questions about skincare routine, what ingredients, when, how much, sunscreen, I strongly advise you, go to ICLS Instagram, in the bio, connect, fill the questionnaire, put a nice photo of you, no makeup, in white light, no worry, only the medical team of ICLS will see these photos. And you will get a reply within 24 hours. If there is the weekend, of course, just you have to wait over the weekend. A real person is very receiving your data and processing your analysis and make your formula for you. I mean, it's a great service, it's available. It's not something that is something that is existing, but right now with the lockdown, you have more time, but also it's a unique opportunity to connect with this unbelievable team with huge knowledge and get your skincare routine, delegate the skincare routine, and build your skincare routine with the right experts.
Very kind, Harry. Thank you very much.
Hopefully I'll see you before Paris, Harris.
Yes.
With all this traveling going on, we're not going to get to see each other much.
Yeah. Well, we have to use new technologies, you know, remote questionnaires, remote diagnostic, Zoom. We will Zoom.
Zoom, yeah.